Now we are going to see rope drives, and these rope drives are generally used when the large amount of power is needed to be transmitted over a longer distance. As we have seen the flat belt drives, these flat belt drives can be used to transmit the power when the distance between the two pulleys is up to 8 meters, 8 meter or 8 to 10 meters. Okay, but if the distance of between the two pulleys increases over the 8 meters, then what happens? The cross-sectional area of the belt increases tremendously, and because of that the self-weight of the belt also increases, which causes excessive load on the pulleys, and that's why the belt drives cannot be used to transmit the power where the distance between the two pulleys is more than the 8 meters. So in that case rope drives are better. Apart from that, to transmit the higher power, generally we say that V belts are having a higher transmission capacity, but rope drives are having a more capacity to transmit the power because the frictional grip is better than the V belt drives. So rope drives is again having advantage over the V belt drives, that the frictional grip is better and it can transmit the power over a longer distance also. Apart from that, one of the advantage of the rope drive is that the number of separate drives may be taken from the one driving pulley. That if we are having a one driving pulley, then a number of separate drives can be taken from it that we can use to run the various application from the one single driving pulley, we can say. Now if we look at the rope drives, there are the two types of ropes which can be used. So we are going to see the type of rope drives. So depending on what type of ropes we are using, there are two types of drives or the rope drives. One is called as a fiber rope drive and another is called as a wire rope drive. Obviously fiber rope drives is made up of the fibrous material, while the wire rope drives are made up of the metals. So fiber rope drives can successfully use when the distance between the two pulleys up to 60 meters. While rope drives can be advantageously used for the distance up to 150 meters between the two pulleys. So wire rope drives we can use up to 150 meters of the when the distance between the two pulleys up to 150 meters. Means we can say over a considerable longer distance, rope drives or the wire rope drives can be used. Now we are going to see the fiber rope drives. For manufacturing the fiber ropes, generally the material which is used is a hemp, manila or the cotton. Whatever this hemp or manila is there, this is a harder material and it is not much flexible, and that's why the rope made from the hemp and manila are not much flexible, and that's why it possesses a poor mechanical properties, because when it moves around the pulley, generally it gets damaged, and that's why its life is considerably reduced, and hemp and manila ropes wear easily. To minimize this wear, generally whatever these ropes which are made up of the hemp and manila, these are lubricated by using the tar, tallow or the graphite, and because of that the wear of the ropes can be minimized. Whatever these ropes made up of the hemps are there, that are only suitable for operating the hand operated machineries such as the tire ropes. Then whatever the cotton ropes are being there, obviously cotton ropes are more flexible and softer, but these are the costlier and these do not need any kind of lubrication. But if lubrication is provided to the cotton ropes, then again its life can be increased. So cotton ropes can also be lubricated by using the tar or the tallow, and its life may be increases, but it is not essential over here. While manila ropes are more durable and stronger compared to the other two types of ropes. Now these rope drives are having the following advantage: they give smooth, steady and quiet service. Then they are little affected by outdoor conditions. The shaft may be out of strict alignment, that it is not necessary that whatever the shafts are there, that should be in the strictly aligned. The power may be taken off in any direction. So both directional power transmission is possible, and they give a high mechanical efficiencies. These are the advantage of the rope drives. Now whatever the pulleys which we are going to use for the fiber rope drives, this will be again the grooved pulleys, and the shape of these pulleys will be again the V-shaped type, and these are called as the shoes pulleys also. So the fiber ropes are usually circular in cross section, and shoes for the fiber ropes are generally V-shaped type. The groove angle, whatever the groove angle for this rope is being there, that is usually up to 45 degree, and that is 45 degree, that angle generally called as a nominated as a 2 beta. If we observe to these particular grooves, you can see these grooves are made narrower at the bottom, and whatever the ropes are being there, that a bottom of this rope do not touch to the bottom of this V grooves, but this rope get pinch in between these two. So whatever the power is being transmitted, that is because of the contact of the ropes at the sides of this grooves or the V grooves, and this rope do not touches at the bottom of the grooves, that we have to take into consideration. Okay, so this will be the pinching effect, and because of that there will be the increase in the friction or the contact between the ropes and the pulley, and that's why we can use there will be the minimum power losses while transmitting the power. Now we will see the wire ropes. When the large amount of power over a longer distance is need to be transmitted, that is up to 150 meters, then wire ropes are generally used. These wire ropes are generally, you may have observed, is widely used in elevators, mine hoist, cranes, conveyors, housing devices, etc. Wire ropes runs on a grooved pulleys. Again, the grooved pulleys will be needed, but here whatever the grooved pulleys will be there, on that grooved pulleys, these wire ropes will rest at the bottom of the grooved pulleys. Unlike the fiber ropes do not rest at the bottom of the grooved pulleys, but wire ropes will rest at the bottom of the grooved pulleys like this. Okay, so whatever the grooved pulleys will be there, it will rest on the bottom. So that is the difference that we have to take into consideration. The advantage of wire rope drives over the fiber rope drives, we are going to see. This is first advantage, these are lighter in weight. Then these offer silent operation. This can withstand shock loads, as these wire ropes are more stronger. Then these are more reliable, they do not fail suddenly. There are obviously very less chances of failing it suddenly. These are more durable, the efficiency is high, and the cost is comparatively low. These are the some examples of the wire rope drives which are used in the various applications. You may have observed it. Then to transmit the power, calculate the power transmitted by the rope drives, all the formulas which we have seen for the power transmission for the flat belt drives or the compound belt drives or the V belt drives, that stands over here. The same formulas we are going to use, only the difference is between the ratio of driving tension for the rope drives. The ratios of driving tension, that is T1 by T2, and for the rope drives, this expression we have to consider is 2.3 log of T1 by T2 is equal to mu theta into cosec beta, where mu is the coefficient of friction between the rope and pulley, theta is angle of contact in radian. In radian, this must be taken, must be remembered, that is whatever the theta or the angle we are going to see, that should be taken in radian and not in degree. And 2 beta is a groove angle of a pulley. Whatever the angle of the groove angle is there, this is generally given as 2 beta, and here we have to consider the beta, cosec beta. So this is the rope brake drive that we have to take into